Are ferrets really stinky? I don't think ferrets stink in the way that everyone has kind of popularized them as being super stinky. One of the reasons I think this is our boys go everywhere with us.
What is their name?
Hagrid, Creature, and Winky. All from Harry Potter.
That is so cute.
And they have met a lot of people. And one of the most common things that people do when they meet our boys, besides wanting to pet them, is they usually pick them up, smell them, and we always get comments that, wow, we really thought they smelled a lot worse than what they do. Or, wow, I thought they stunk.
Ew.
So I know some people are gonna just say we're nose blind to them and that we just can't tell anymore, but when complete strangers are telling us that they don't really stink bad, I'm pretty sure that answers the question. Now, if you find that your ferret does smell a little bit, there's some things that you can do to reduce that smell. The first thing, which isn't the most obvious, is don't give them baths. When people start to notice their ferret getting a little bit stinky, the most commonly done thing is give them a bath, because that would make sense, right? If it smells, bathe it and it won't smell anymore, right? Wrong. It's actually the opposite of that. The more baths you give ferrets, usually the stinkier they're going to be. I'll link a video up top that goes over how to bathe your ferret, but you really should not be bathing your ferret more than once or twice a year. A ferret's skin produces oils that'll coat the fur. When you bathe them, it actually strips the oils, and then the body works extra hard to try to reproduce those oils. And they actually get stinkier because of that, because it's actually overproducing at that point. So the more baths, the more oils, and the stinkier they get. The second way to make your ferret less stinky is one of the more obvious reasons, and that's clean their cage. For our boys, twice a day, I scoop their litter box. And the rest of the cage, I'll usually vacuum if they get any extra fur. Sometimes they will spill food down here with their food dishes, and I just vacuum it up real quick. Besides the daily cleaning, once a week, I change out all of their bedding. So they've got cloth on those shelves, cloth on this shelf here. They have this cloth cubby, this cloth bed. There's a cloth bed down there, a cloth hammock, and they have all these cloth toys. So once a week, all that comes out and actually gets washed in our washer and then dried in our dryer. All of those cloth things can really hold some of those oils we talked about, which can be kind of smelly. And when they go to lay down on that, you're just putting the smelly stuff back on their fur. And a third way to make them not so stinky is feeding them a species-appropriate diet. So when you look at their teeth and look at their digestive tract, it shows that ferrets are obligate carnivores, meaning they should be eating meat. The closest you can get to the species-appropriate diet, the less smellier they're going to be. So the best diet for ferrets is actually a balanced raw meat diet. A diet like that will make them the least smelliest. If you can't do a raw meat diet, it's important to find a kibble that's appropriate for your ferrets. These kibbles are going to be high in protein and not have a lot of fillers and carbohydrates. Unfortunately, most ferret kibbles out there are not actually very appropriate for ferrets. And if you start feeding something that has a lot less protein in it and isn't very species appropriate, that's when you start to get the really, really smelly ferrets. There's a couple reasons people think ferrets smell. One of the reasons is because a lot of times, one of the only times they come in contact with ferrets is at pet stores. And pet stores don't always take care of their ferrets the best way they can. Pet stores don't normally feed the best kind of diets, so that's gonna cause them to be a little stinkier. And the enclosures pet stores tend to keep their ferrets in has a lot to do with why they seem so stinky. Oftentimes they're not in cages, they're usually in some type of plexiglass or glass enclosure. So that really keeps any stink there would be really enclosed inside that enclosure as opposed to a cage where that smell can kind of dissipate. These enclosures normally are filled with some type of substrate. So some type of paper kind of a bedding or something that's all crumpled in there. And a lot of them will have a litter box in there with some other type of substrate in there. However, because the whole thing's filled with different substrates, a lot of the times those ferrets are going to the bathroom all over their enclosure, not just in the litter box. They often use the really small triangular litter boxes, which most ferrets don't really like anyways, which also contributes to them going to the bathroom all over their enclosure. And then when they go to lay down or play in the rest of their enclosure that's not in the litter box because they've had accidents all over, they're gonna smell like that, unfortunately. So although there are ways to reduce the smell of a ferret, I do want to warn people, they do still have their own unique smell. I think that every animal out there will always have a smell. Obviously, people know what horses smell like. I think dogs have a specific smell, especially a wet dog. Even our parrots have like a bird smell. So it's best that if for some reason you don't like a little bit of a musky smell, instead of buying one of these, you should buy one of these.